Alright, so the second part is the grand recognizer unification. It's trying to work with Bernd, and actually the IDE part is also trying to work with Bernd, but that was just my presentation of it. Here you also have a paper. So basically, there are benefits to uniformity, even though maybe some have the idea that, yeah, we optimize everything specific to a specific kind of data type, and then we get the maximum performance or something like that. We get lots of benefits from uniformity, and examples are that in Unix everything is a file, and files are not something like records or something like in earlier file systems, but sequences of bytes. In object-oriented programming, you have different kinds of things that are in some way different, but are similar in other respects, like you have a circle that you want to draw, and you have a triangle that you want to draw, and you can combine them as one graphical object that, and have a draw method for it. And this was a big success. And also FORF has benefits from uniformity. In FORF, everything is a word. So it's, you don't have a difference between an operator and a function call. You don't have a difference between something built in and something user defined. Everything is a word. Also, addresses, integers, and XTs are cells, so you can use everything that's that works on cells on these. So the next step in this kind of quest for uniformity is to see that we have now four different concepts for recognizing a string in the text interpreter. And basically, this is a table where we have word lists and recognizers on one dimension, and one of them or many of them in the other dimension. And so if you have one word list, it's a word list. If you have one recognizer, it's a recognizer. If you have many word lists, you have a search order. And if you have many recognizers, it's a recognizer sequence. And for, traditionally, for all these, we have different words for doing the recognizing. So for a word list, we have find name in. For a recognizer, we have execute. For a search order, we have find name, and for a recognizer sequence, we have recognize. And what this talk is about is combining all this in all these things to behave like a recognizer. So you, in the end, you can all you can use execute on all of them. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is one part of treating word lists as recognizers. A word list IT is implemented as the execution token of a recognizer, and the recognizer must have this kind of stack effect. So you give it a string and it returns either an NT and rectype NT, or it returns rectype null. So this is the same kind of stack effect as recNT does, which is basically the search order recognizer. But you also have to implement findNameIn. So you still have all the traditional users that use findNameIn, and you may say, why findNameIn? Well, in that case, if you still also have the traditional users that use find, then you have to do something similar, but I'm going to explain it with the example of findNameIn, which is pretty easy. So you pass a string and word list ID, and the word list ID is the execution token of a recognizer to findNameIn. So the first thing that findNameIn does is it executes this word list recognizer. And the only problem you now have is that you have this kind of result and not this kind of result. And basically this code is what turns this kind of result into this kind of result. And I'll go into the low level implementation later because that's pretty system specific. Whereas much of the rest of the talk is actually quite not very system specific. So the next point I'm looking at is treating recognizer sequences as recognizers. So here's the definition of a recognizer sequence. So we have one. We pass n recognizers and their number to this word list, to this defining word rec sequence, and it does the usual create does thing. And so in the creation part, it stores the maximum capacity, it stores the current capacity, and it stores the individual recognizers. In the does part, this is pretty involved, but basically the thing is that it fetches a recognizer, it executes it, and then it checks, did it recognize something? So if it recognizes something, then the result is not rectype null. And if it recognized something, it unloops and exits, and then we are done. And if it didn't recognize something, it drops this rectype null and continues. And when it has gone through all the recognizers and hasn't found anything, it returns rectype null. So the next thing, we also have accessor words. So we get rec sequence, which gets the recognizers in a recognizer sequence, and set rec sequence on the next screen. And the only remarkable thing about this is that we follow defers because we want to be able to put deferred words into a recognizer sequence and have them transparent there. So you can put the deferred word there and then put the recognizer in the deferred word. So yeah, set rec sequence, also not really remarkable. And then we continue with the search order as recognizer. So basically, we have done most of the work in the recognizer sequences. So here we just want to implement get order and set order. And this is pretty easy. Get order just takes the search order and treats it as a recognizer sequence and gets the contents of the recognizer sequence. What is the search order? The search order is a recognizer sequence, and we start by filling it with 16 placeholder recognizers. So these are basically no-op recognizers that always return a rectype null. So we now have a search order. Here we have the thing we need to do for dealing with only, and this line is also for dealing with only. And here we see if we want to set order and don't have to deal with only, we do a set rec sequence on the search order. So what can we put in the search order? Can we put any recognizer in the search order? No, we can't, because find name in must still work. So anything we put into the search order must have this stack effect. And traverse word list must work. So that's something, so if we want to deal with non-word list recognizers, there maybe we need some special dealings in a traverse word list. So One other point is how to deal with locals. So basically, the position I take here is that find and find name has to first search locals and then the search order. And of course, only if locals are active. So here we assume we have a locals recognizer that has the typical NT type thing. We defer rec NT. We make that a deferred word. And we have now a recognizer sequence that contains the search order on the bottom and rec local, so that this locals recognizer on the top. And we can activate the locals by putting this recognizer sequence into recNT, or we can deactivate the locals by putting the search order without locals into recNT. And find name now is just we have this recNT thing, which is a deferred word, so we use this transparent part and call find name in. So finally, the implementation of word lists as recognizers. The old implementation. So this is a G4 specific slide. So already the old implementation was object oriented. So we had this virtual method table pointer, which was called a map and had a number of methods. And we had three other fields. And the new implementation implements this. So this is a specific structure which only is useful for word lists. And here we have an actual word. And this, so the XT of the word is the width. It also has a new field, the code field, which uses todas and through todas invokes this rec method, and this rec corresponds to the find here. We also have the others in some way, and since time is running out, I'm not going into it. The fields are also there. So it's not that different. But we can now treat it as a word, for example, executed. So in conclusion, uniformity allows better factoring. We can unify word list search order recognizers and the recognizer sequences into one thing, which are recognizers. The search order becomes a recognizer sequence, the word list becomes a recognizer word, and that's it. Thank you. Questions?
Thank you, Anton, for this great talk and great unification approach. Are there any questions?
Yes.
Please.
Steve.
I well understand the similarity between the data structuring of search order and recognizer. What I don't see is the programmer, the user benefit of this approach. And it seems to me to add a level, I'd almost say levels of complexity to what benefit? Where are both the internal and external benefits of this approach? Or is it too early to tell?
I think that the general benefit is the uniformity, and you see the benefits along the way. So one thing we have, for example, is we have currently a list of word lists, which is of all word lists in the system, which is a special data structure. And one thing we are considering is creating an ordinary word list of from this, and then we can use traverse word list to go through all this instead of having the a separate code for going through this list. So just one example.
But that's an internal benefit.
Oh yes, yes. It's also mostly internal benefits. I'm not sure. I mean, of course, if a user does some system level programming, they may also see benefits.
But in order, for example, my example yesterday was pushing a Nuke package in and out of the system, where you have to deal both with the recognizer for the OOP package for the parsing, and you have to deal with search order.
Yes, and you can create a single recognizer sequence for your OOP package containing both the search order and the dot parser or whatever you have inside. Maybe you have a one stop point then for putting the OOP package in and out.
Have you tried it?
We don't have this kind of OOP package.
But you have Bernd's OOP package, which will never go away.
The Bernd's OOP package I'm now using has a very simple structure, and the old one is not ported to this approach.
Okay.
It's not used by me at the moment.
Maybe somebody else also has a question instead of letting this drift.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Last question.
There's no standard way of seeing all the word lists in the system, is there currently? We can see what's in the search order, obviously, but
yes,
there could be word lists that are defined.
Yes, there is currently no standard way to do this. In GFOF, you can say vox, V-O-C-S, and you will see this. And basically, this uses this list of word lists, which are currently a separate data structure. And the benefit I was alluding to is to simplify this by factoring the word list handling, so this handling of this list into general word list handling.
Right. I mean, of course, the user can always redefine word list to make a table to keep track of everything that's being defined. But it seems like if you are dealing with a lot of modules or a lot of packages, which go into word lists, then there needs to be a way of seeing everything.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Anton, for these two very exciting talks. And
my pleasure.
I'm sure